So you have a model with textures and now you want to animate it. To get started, go to top right and click animate. Before you can do any animating, you have to go to the animations window and click add animation. Give it a name and select whether or not you want it to loop. All of these properties can be changed later if you need to. Make sure you have your animation selected and you can get started. There are two different types of animations. Keyframe animation, where you make the start and end points of an action and the program fills in everything in between. And math-based animations, where you use Molang expressions to animate. We're going to focus on keyframe animation. In the outliner, you will notice that all of the cubes in the folders are gone. This is because these are the bones we use to animate and all animations use the pivot points of these bones. Any transformation you apply while in animate mode will count as part of the animation and you will not see it when you go back to the edit tab. There is one exception, which is changing the pivot point. That would be a permanent change in the model, as you can see it in the edit tab. Animation length can be controlled by dragging the bracket, or by typing it in the animations window. When you click a bone in your model, you will see it appear in the timeline. Here you can set rotation, position, and scale. If you click the plus symbol next to these, you will create a keyframe on your current time. If you click anywhere on top of the timeline, you move your current time there. You can also type in the exact time you want to be on. You cannot create keyframes for cubes without folders. You can copy keyframes with Ctrl plus C and paste with Ctrl plus V. To move the keyframes, just click and drag. To select multiple, hold Ctrl and select or drag for a selection box. To add rotation, you can use the rotate tool or type it in the keyframe window. If you want to preserve the round numbers, you should make sure you rotate in relation to the bone by changing transform mode to bone. Now when we hit space or click play, you can see that the bone goes from the first rotation to the second, then back to the original. You can also see that any bones nested within will move with it. If you right-click the animation and go to loop mode, you can change it to loop, and as you can see, it now repeats infinitely. If you click toggle graph editor or press F3, you can see a graph showing how the animation accelerates with one graph for each direction. This is known as interpolation, and it can be changed in the keyframe window. Select the keyframes and pick smooth interpolation. You can now see that the animation automatically eases in and out to create a more smooth movement. If you select step, there will be no interpolation, meaning you will instantly jump between frames. Now, if we toggle off the graph editor, we can flip the animation to the opposite side. Select all the keyframes by pressing Ctrl plus A, then hit Ctrl plus C to copy and select the opposite bone. Make sure you're at the start of the animation and press Ctrl plus V to paste. Optionally, if you have named the bones right and left, you can go to animation, flip animation, and this will automatically mirror the selected keyframes. You can then select the new keyframes, go to animation, flip keyframes, and select flip Y. If you want to reverse the order of a range of keyframes, select those keyframes, then go to animation, reverse keyframes. You can also change the original model into the current position by going to animation, bake animation into model. Now when you go to edit, you can see the model has retained that position. To move a bone, make some position keyframes and change them. When we play this, you can see that the bone moves as well as the pivot point. You can also scale the bone in any direction using the pivot point as a center of the scaling. If you want to scale from a different point, you have to go back to the edit tab, add another bone within the bone, a sub-bone if you will, move everything into the new bone, then change the pivot point where you want it. You can put it in the center by clicking center pivot. If we then go back to animate and scale it, it will now scale from the center of the bone. You can also give things a negative scale, which will flip it, or give it a scale of 0, which will make it flat. If you make it 0 in all directions, it will disappear completely. A useful trick if you want to disable a bone mid-animation is making it go to 0 scale and changing interpolation to stepped. This can also be used to detach bones from one another by creating a hidden copy which is enabled simultaneously as you disable the original. While scaling, any bones nested within will scale in relation to the parent bone. If you want to scale them individually, you will have to go back to edit and create a subbone, scale that, then change the position of the original joint into place. Once you have a lot of animations, it can be hard to keep track of them all, in which case it can be helpful to use filter channels to filter out the animation types you don't need or hide empty channels. You can also clear bones from the timeline by clicking the minus symbol or by clicking clear timeline. To bring them back up, you can click bring up all animations. If you click the flag symbol, you will create a marker at your current time. This is the type of checkpoint you can click to go back to that time. You can also right click it to change the color. If you want to add a particle effect to the model, you will need a keyframe file, basically a pre-made particle effect which can make in snowstorm, link below. You will also need to add a locator to dictate where the effect will occur. Now click animate effects and add a keyframe. Select your locator and click select keyframe file, then select the particle effect you want to use. You can also add sound cues and instructions that will appear in the code if you want to relay any messages for any potential programmers using your model. In math animation, instead of using keyframes, we use a trigonometric function that will give us an infinitely repeating animation. You can make a function using the Molang grapher linked below, then copy it into the desired keyframe direction. If you toggle on the graph editor, you can see how the interpolation has become a graph. When you play the animation, you can see it is very smooth and will repeat infinitely. I have linked a bunch of useful resources in the description below. And with that, you have all the tools needed to animate the model.